Okay, folks. Fast forward to 29-23-ish. Maybe a little more, maybe a little less. About 29-23. Then I'll watch to the end. Then go back and restart. Got it? Perfect. 29-23. Watch to the end. Then restart. Good deal.
Straw Family Farm. I'm Christy.
I'm not ready.
Okay, so not ready. Let's get you in the frame here. There you go. Alright. In the chapel, what do you got for us? Because tonight's legs night on the farm.
Proverbs 14:1, I think. Yeah. The wise woman builds her house, but with her own hands. The foolish one tears her down.
Yep. Say it to the camera now.
The wise woman builds her house, but with her own hands.
Yep.
The foolish one tears hers down.
Yep. So, be wise, build your house up. Not just physically, but with your words. We talked about that last week. And don't be a foolish woman and tear your house apart. So, all right, that's in honor of Ladies' Night tonight. Pizza rolls. Yeah, that's our lunch.
So your lunch.
I'm eating. So, all right, in the barn stall, tell us everything that's been going on. Don't forget the ducks, the chicks, the everything. Just everything. Sure.
Okay. First, Mom's been on a clean rampage since 5 o'clock yesterday till about 2 o'clock this morning. Then I woke up to her. I don't even know if she's been to bed yet, folks.
Barn stall's about the animals. I'm not
but
an animal.
But she's been cleaning. She's been cleaning like a mad animal. We're about ready to lock her in the barn for the night. Mm-hmm. She cleaned the barn. And let's see. We got 4 ducks that their mama's not taking care of them right. So
yeah,
they're in the bathroom.
It was the duck that hatched 2 chicks
and 4 ducks.
4 ducks.
And she was getting confused. So
she was doing really good with them. And then all of a sudden, in 2 days, she just started leaving them. And to a point where the one male duck was beating up on the one duck that tried to stay with him.
Yep.
Shaking the table. So, where are they all at now?
In the bathroom.
And we took and split the 2 chicks off and put them with the other one that
the
had...
The chicks. Chicks were chicks, ducks were ducks.
Yes. Now, why are they like that?
Because we don't have a tote bag to stick them all together.
Mm-hmm.
And,
what food did I buy?
Oh, Mom bought Chick Starter the other day, so it's got medication in it, so they can't eat it.
So. Yeah, so ducks can't have medicated feed, and that's what we have for the chicks, right?
Right.
Wrong. Okay.
Wrong.
Right.
Left. Right. Right. Left. Right. Left.
Okay.
Right there, Clyde.
Bam. What happened this week with Kawaii? What happened with Kawaii?
I don't know.
You do too. Tell them what happened with Kavayu. Come on.
I've been saddling him and getting him working
yep.
with him.
And Dirk is being rode, right?
Yep.
So that means all of our horses are saddleable. He's playing with the pig. Bring her up here.
She laid down. Smile, you're on camera.
I'm yum yum. Put her down. Yum yum. Yum yum. I know. She loves RJ. RJ, tell what happened with her this week. What did she learn to do?
Jump on the couch.
What happened to you?
I decided I'd take a nap yesterday on the couch. And she wanted to join me. And kersplat, she went. Right in the middle of me.
RJ was sound asleep, and all of a sudden, here he comes, this flying pig landing on him.
Whoa!
And after she... And after you freaked out, what'd she do?
Curled up and went to sleep with me for a while. Probably about 30 minutes. Then she got thirsty or hot, so she just crawled back over me and went off.
Mm-hmm. So anyway, saddle Kavayu. and dirt, and they're the last two. That means, and you've been riding star.
Yep.
So that means, technically, all of the horses are green broke.
Yeah,
except for Cavayu.
Cavayu's not. I haven't got on him.
Haven't got on him?
Mm-mm.
All in due time. All in due time.
What's that Hione first?
I'm too big right now. I have to be losing some weight.
So. I won't be a buck very hard if you be.
Anyway, alright. Moving on to mending fences.
We
got, you got the alternator on the truck, right?
Huh?
You got the transmission. Oh, I forgot the transmission fluid, too. Mm. You got the transmission changed in the 82. Yours needs a mechanic again. There's something loose in there, a loose wire, and as soon as the mechanic figures out exactly which one, we'll be able to put it on there good, and it will always start, right?
Yeah.
So, what else?
We still have yet to receive $1 million in a beach house that was sent to us.
Nobody
could
sent
somebody resend that, please?
What else did we fix on? Some fence?
I'd settle for $1 most of the time. I'm not that big. But I asked for a lot. So that way.
So, anyway, mending fences. We fixed the fence.
My eye.
It's called your finger.
No, my finger's not it.
Well, here, let me. Let me oblige you. Oh, what did you get in the mail today? Or yesterday?
My phone cable.
Yes. So, got that fixed. What else? Cleaned
still
up the barn.
There. Help me, help me.
Just
I'm going
cry
blind.
It out. Just cry it out.
That's no joke. I need my cry to wash it out.
Is it in your good eye or your bad eye?
My good one.
Well, you're blind. Alright. What's going on in your farm? We only have one more week with our intern.
I got something in my eye, folks.
We're having ladies' night tonight. Which, ladies' night is... We're opening the farm to the ladies. No topic is off topic. Anything you ever wanted to know about a woman in farming, from different ways that I do things, different, I mean, I don't work the sheep the same as they do. I don't catch the sheep the same as they do. I don't catch the cattle the same as they do. All that stuff and much, much more. It's no woman topic is off topic tonight, and we've got some ladies coming out and we're just gonna have some fun. I might see if they'll let us video, maybe not. I don't know. So, right?
Right.
All right. What else going on in your own farm? Nothing really?
No.
In the fields. Well, and just so you know, ladies' night, we're having some wine and cheesecake, and everybody else is bringing us
stuff. Yeah, I did the leftover cheesecake. I just have to, like, lock the freezer, duct tape it shut so they can't get it out.
And for all those that are going to criticize, if you drink, if you bring an alcoholic beverage or you're caught drinking, your keys are deposited with the farm manager for the night. The barn is open to sleep in all night long. One lady says she's depositing her keys and she's not even going to fight with it. She says, I'm going to have some wine. I'll sleep in the barn. She's actually bringing a lounge chair for her to sleep in. She's just planning on staying. So that is fine by me.
We'll let you know how it moves.
Mm-hmm. But I won't be responsible for anybody drinking and driving. So next, what's up? I've got a pig between my feet. Woo!
Hey, pig! Hey, pig!
I've got sleeping bags airing out, that kind of stuff, but we're going to talk everything from gardening to handling animals, spinning,
Mom, I just gotta drink. Keep
knitting.
Drive.
Dork.
It but, is a drink. It's in a glass.
Okay,
from.
And I will do a little video on this, but there are
no, you won't.
Your pig just fell over. But there is a wine called 19 Crimes, and there's an app on your phone. RJ is losing it. It's creepy, isn't it?
Yeah, I'd hate to see that drunk.
I'm not going to get drunk, but I probably will drink the wine. It's a red wine. The only one that she had was a red wine. It wasn't a white wine, which
Everybody
is what my friend's
white.
It's white wine. But it on my phone, you scan the label, like you hold the picture of the label, and once it recognizes the label, the person on the label talks to you about the crime it was convicted of. And its mouth moves and its head moves just like it's talking. But yet you can see my fingers from holding the bottle in the picture. It's creepy. It really is creepy, but it's fun. It's just a simple little app. Don't get all, I know online they haven't rated it, but you know, so many stars, and it's just for fun. People need to back off. There's some wines out there that they're called the living wine. So yeah, each bottle tells you a history. The lady from the liquor store, Linda, she's known him since he was three. He's sold her eggs back when he was three. For the exact price of a candy bar. Just saying.
I'm gonna plug in.
That's gross. Say squishy.
Excuse me, folks.
Anyway, she's known him all his life, but she told me about it, and she said they did it at Thanksgiving. She can't even remember if they drank the wine, number one, and number two, whether it was good or not. Nobody can remember, because they remember passing the bottle around, but they don't remember whether the bottle was empty. And she said if it was empty, then it was obviously a good wine. She said, but she doesn't even remember them opening it. Like, they all just played with the label. So I have no clue whether the wine's going to be good or not. But it's a red wine. So
I got a piggy on my feet.
Mm-hmm.
This little piggy went to market. This little piggy stayed
home. So, anyway.
This little piggy had roast beef. This little piggy had none.
And her tail is just thumping against my
This ankle. Little piggy went wee-wee-wee-wee all the way home.
Mm-hmm.
And she's home. See?
She's just sitting on us. Anyway.
The life of a pig. I'm going to be like her.
Alright, let's move on to in the farmhouse. No, in the field. Squash bug has got a lot of my plants. I still have my herb garden going. Some of the pumpkins germinated where we dropped them in the other pasture, so I'm leaving them and waiting to see if I get anything off of those. I might get pumpkins.
Can you see any of my
eyeball? No, I'm back to the eye dye. Okay, let's move on to in the farmhouse, because you can talk about your eyeball. He's got something in his eye, obviously.
Still.
I got my other contacts back. So now I'm just doing the focusing thing. This is for distance, and this is so I can see y'all clearly. Out there.
I look at the one. Is there the one I was supposed to?
No, not on camera. This looks dorky.
Come on, what?
Finish the podcast first. Look with the one eye that's good. No! Okay, next. How'd you do last night? You rodeoed. How'd you do?
I did pretty good. I won it first. I put 7-9. So.
We'll see how many. You got, what, 20 ropers here tonight?
Yep.
So, in all honesty, a 7-9 normally will place.
Should.
So. And by the grace of God, it'll win it, won't it?
Yep.
Because that's a ACRA sanctioned rodeo?
Yep.
That money counts for its finals?
Yep.
Okay, you gotta tell them.
Oh, yeah.
What does all that mean?
The guys that win, the top 15 money winners will go to the finals. And
through the whole season. So you rodeo all season.
And the top 15 that win the most money get to go to
the finals. Compete at finals. Or yep. The title of champion or whatever.
Yep. I don't want you. You're a dog. You're not a pig.
Hey, Moose Moose.
Get out. Thank you.
Anything else?
Okay, fine. I'll pet on you. Good dog.
What
good
else
dog.
Has been going on? Come on.
I'm petting on the dog.
We mowed.
Yeah, I mowed.
Mowed. You fixed the picnic table and stuff. That was in Mending Fences, and you didn't tell him.
I put a screw in a picnic table. Pow, pow. That's all I did.
Yep, I have a package going out here that's going to go out Wednesday.
What's this?
Her address. No. Surprise, you can't show me.
Nobody told me we were sending out surprise packages to.
Alright.
Where are we sending
it
to? I want to give hints. We are sending it.
It goes to Canada. That's why I don't want you to say it. Anyway.
If you're listening, and you Lily Canada.
Oh, she's
might get a package. We have lots of viewers in Canada. It's a select few. So, just so you focus.
If you're watching from Canada, your odds are good you're going to be getting a package.
Yeah, unless like all of Canada's watching.
Okay, so we have one thing that is big that is...
We do? What?
Yes, you Skyped. We Skyped. We learned to Skype.
Yeah.
And we learned to Skype for a reason.
We did.
Oh, yeah.
Who did we Skype with?
That one lady.
Raya is what we call her. I think it's Moraya, Myraya? I don't know. We call her Raya.
We can't pronounce names, okay, folks?
I call her Raya.
We use initials around here.
Well, she's also known as the Concrete Kid. And she has a YouTube channel. I'll put her link down below. But what is so exciting for Raya?
Oh, she is.
Because she called me, and she said she wanted to attend rodeo. It's on her bucket list, and I told her, there's rodeos all over the world. You can go. And she said, no. She says, I want to go with somebody. And she says, if I can get it pulled off, if I come to your house, Will, you guys say, I said, well, if you come here, I said, we'll put you to work. Well, you can be RJ's groom for the weekend and you make two or three rodeos. Okay. You can do two or three rodeos. And then on Sunday, when he goes to work the roping, you can work the cattle at the rodeo. And so she is all over it. And she is super excited. She's trying to get here for Cowboy Christmas. I know she's trying to raise some money and that. We're putting her, she's going to stay here. We're providing her food, all that kind of stuff. And we're going to haul her around. So we'll pick her up at the airport and all that. But she's got to pay for her ticket. I just don't have that kind of money. So she is, I don't know what all she's doing. But she is pushing to try and get the money raised. So, RJ?
Yeah. Food comes first, folks.
He's making corn on the cob. So he's got a cob. And he says food comes first. But anyway, she's going to come here. The plan is right now, and it's just a tentative plan, that she flies in Thursday night. She'll have Friday with us to learn some things. And then Friday night, she'll go rodeo. Saturday, she'll get to do some stuff. And the thing is that she wants to learn about being a cowboy. She wants to be a cowboy. And I guess a cowgirl in her case. But we're going to have her on a horse. We're going to make her do chores. She's going to see what it's really like to get up, get the chores done, go to the rodeo. You know, our thing is that we work hard and we play harder. And we do. So she'll be out here grooming horses, exercising horses, she'll be riding. We're going to try and teach her to rope so that she knows what she's doing. And then Sunday she's going to be a chute hand, and she'll be pushing the cattle up into the chute for the guys roping. She's going to try it all, but we just have to get her here. So go over and check out her channel and see what all she's got going on. She's trying to get it together. She woofed with My Mobile Homestead, and I know she's talked to a couple of other, she's got some other things in the works, so we're just of many things that she wants to do. We're hoping to be able to pull this off, and she's gonna get video. She is super duper excited. We told her about some of the daily chores that have to be done. She was not impressed. But if you don't do the daily chores, you don't get to go to the rodeo. So she's like, okay, I'll do it. How excited was she on the phone?
She's about as excited as a kid in a candy shop.
On Christmas Day.
With unlimited budget.
Yep. I know it's hot, but you want to show it. Look, corn on the cup.
With a side of butter.
It's actually a little butter with
it. It's not a little butter like corn. There's 4 ears of corn.
That's a lot of butter. Anyway, so she is super excited. We're hoping that she'll get to come out here. There are a few things that we plan on Her doing?
I guess that butter didn't melt because it's cold.
Nope. We'll have pictures of her riding bidet.
It's butt look quick, look.
Nobody wants to look at your tongue. Put it up. Mm. If you don't want that thing in your mouth, none of us want it out here either.
It's kind of hot.
I don't care. Get a drink.
Oh, I should turn on the air conditioner. That'll cool it down.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, on top. Now he's got me down a rabbit hole about food. Anyway, she is... Sorry, the pig keeps knocking the little thing out. And I keep thinking that it's unplugging. We're so down a rabbit hole. He's talking about his hot food. I'm like, the thing, and we're supposed to be talking about our visitor. Raya the Concrete Kid is supposed to be coming here. And that's what we're supposed to be talking about.
I think they got
guys.
The gist. You've said it like 3 times. That's all you keep telling them today.
I know. Anyway, so she's going to ride Bidet the cow. She's going to, she does have kind of a fear of horses, but that is going to go by the wayside. She'll get over it. There's 7 of them out here. There's donkeys. If she can handle Murphy, she can handle any of them. He's a miniature donkey. We have her in training. We talked to her about she needs to be able to lift the saddle 75 pounds up over her head because she's only 5 foot. I'm only like 2 inches taller than her. So she's got to be able to throw that saddle up on the horse's back. What else did we tell her? She's got to learn to braid their manes and their tails so that, and yes, we really do that for roping purposes, and we'll explain that with her when we do it, because it's not something that we really talk about, but yeah, braid a horse's mane and tail. What were some of the others that she had to do? Learn to rope. She's got to practice her roping skills. What else did we have? That's my phone. Oh, that's our horse.
Our what?
Forks for tonight. I have spoons, I just don't have forks.
Oh.
Anyway.
Who needs forks, anyways?
For cheesecake.
When we eat,
you're not even talking about
and I don't
want to
do dishes,
that,
I can
oh,
eat
I'll
a lot
flip.
Of things with spoons. Alright, folks, I am the master of not doing dishes. Like, I'll eat a steak with a spoon and a butter knife if I have to.
Okay, so I told Raya that she had to practice lifting. She has to open the horse's mouths. And she asked me, she's like, how do you do that? And I said, well, pretty much, if you've ever given your kid medicine that they don't want to take when they're little and they lock their jaw closed, I said, just practice getting your kid's jaw open. Braiding the mane, flanking a calf, and practice roping a calf. And then, she has to be able to feed the sheep and keep her balance. So, and she's little, they're going to run her over. Budgie, if she jumps on her, that it's all over. But she did tell me that she is not afraid to land on her butt, correct? She's like, the more it happens, the better. She says, I just want to know everything that can go wrong. And so, she's not scared to get in there and get it done. So... Yep, it could be interesting. We'll see how it goes. The big thing is right now she is raising money to get this done. I don't know. I think she's doing a t-shirt, right?
Yep. Plane tickets quite a bit.
The plane ticket is her big expense, and that's what she's doing. So,
plane tickets are not cheap, folks. Just an FYI.
No. But there's a reason that she's trying to come that weekend. It's known as Cowboy Christmas. RJ, you want to tell them what Cowboy Christmas is? You just burnt your mouth anyway, so you can't eat that one either. When is Cowboy Christmas?
It's on the 4th of July.
It's that whole
week. It's like
week.
The week before to the week after, probably.
Yep, and why is it called that? There's
more
rodeos
that weekend than there is any other time of the year. Those 2 weeks, there's more rodeos than there is.
So if you can map it out and do it, you can make a lot of rodeos, correct? Yeah. And you can rack up your points in that. And there's guys that go 4th of July and maybe a few others and make finals, correct?
Yep.
So, around here, 4th of July entertainment is the rodeo. So you go to rodeo and the fireworks show, right?
All the same place, too.
Yep, and they do it all at the same place. Rodeo's put on a good show. It's
entertainment.
Better
get all of your horses.
There's food, yeah. You do have to get a hold of your horsey. Or you might regret it.
Might be chasing for a while.
Yep. But anyway, so that's why she's trying to come then, because she wants to see and do the rodeo experience, the whole rodeo experience. And we plan on giving her that, correct? Mm-hmm. Along with the farm adventure. So, all right, anything else that's going on in the house? We'll do videos with her, and we'll have more videos going up. RJ's having struggling to get on a schedule. Facebook posts, blog posts, and YouTube.
Struggle is real, folks.
Yep. And I used to take care of all of that, didn't I? Well, the blog, not really. I just edited. So, I put in the pictures and that. You type all the words. But here lately, he's been coming in, been too tired, taking a nap. He's going to have to get over that. Because I'm at work and I can't force him to do it. So, he's going to have to get on it and be put his big boy panties on and get things going.
I lost all of them.
You got your Superman ones, don't you?
I lost those too.
Oh, then it's Batman, right?
I gave those away.
Flash, the Armed Avenger.
I got rid of that.
Lone Ranger, Long John Silver's. I don't know.
I don't want to be a superhero anymore.
I even think you'd just be a big boy.
No, mommy, I am.
Yes, you can. We're working on a schedule, so it should be Tuesday and Thursday. I'm going to start doing a gardening video on my day off on Wednesday to help out. And then he's going to do an animal one, whatever's going on that week. And then he's going to try doing a post on Facebook at noon and keep things moving. So
I had a picture the other day, and I was going to make a post on Facebook. And then I kind of came in, make lunch, and I sat down and fell asleep.
Yeah, because did the Jell-O one ever show up?
No.
See, you have all those pictures on your phone. You could just go to posting them. You could schedule them.
Like that one that I fell asleep, my phone died, and you were like, why have you not been answering your phone?
Yeah, I went to get the tag on the truck, though, and I needed to get
a I just sat in and sat down and got a drink and just fell asleep. I mean, just...
Yeah, it's the heat. So, anyway... We do more online in the winter, but we're struggling to iron it out and get things done in the summer so that it's consistent. Anything else?
Yeah.
What?
We're consistently inconsistent.
I was thinking that about my bowling the other day. And I haven't even gotten ready, so I'm going to get off here and get ready, huh? Because that was Jane, and I didn't even read the text because I have to do the one eye thing. Make them focus.
I still have another one on a copy.
No.
Can you read? No, she can't be focused. It's taking her too long. It's like three lines.
She's gonna get the quartz.
We know that. You already
but
said
that. But
there's
your cousin dropping by or something, too. So, that's okay. Right.
This is some good porn.
Corn for a corny kid.
You are what you eat.
Yep, you're corny. Mm-hmm. Okay. Alright, on that note, Corny and I are going to get off of here, right? And
I still got
for...
one more to eat though, Mom.
I'm going to sit here the whole time while you eat it. Okay, what are you going to talk about while you eat it? How nummy nummy it is? Hmm?
That can be arranged.
But you're not talking, you're just eating in front of them, and that's rude.
Well, how do you know they're not eating, too?
Well, they should be eating, because we invite everybody to grab something, drink, whatever, so.
You didn't do that this time.
I haven't done that in a long time. It's because you get me off course, and you're like, is it on? Oh, this time I just like, this is Christy. Didn't even tell them who.
Don't forget to get a drink and a snack and have a meal with us, guys.
Oh, Lord. Yeah. Anyway.
Watch the last 30 seconds and go back to the beginning and rewatch it. I make that like the last 5 minutes, you know, because we're probably going to still talk for a little while before we get to
No, we're not, because I'm about done, right? We've got everything. Oh, no, we don't.
See ya, doll job.
Okay, so the other thing that's going on is I have to figure out the goats were exposed, but we don't think they're pregnant. And we have two sheep that we think were exposed, but I think only one took. The other one, anytime she cycles, she goes out by the man pen, so I don't think she got bred. So when is our fall stuff supposed to be certain?
In the fall.
Yeah, not really. In summer. And then when are the cattle due?
I don't know.
Yep, that would be September, right? Because cows carry for 9 months. And we put him in January 1st or December 1st. So, it'll be coming up. This is July. It'll be in a month or so that they'll be due. My hair is poking me in the ear. Anyway, so here in just a few months, we'll start having things birth. But not like the magnitude that we had before. It might be, it's either one or two sheep, or one or two goats, and three head of cattle, right? So that's it. So we're talking 2, 4, 7 or 8 things. Well, if the sheep do twins, you know, or the goats do twins or triplets, so 10 head, maybe, right? Okay. So, and he ate them all. That's what he wanted to show. But, remember that, start thinking about those names that are, what is it, gemstones?
I want to pick one. I want to pick one. I want to, like, movie characters, TV show characters. Do some cool ones, folks. Gemstones. Really? Gemstones.
Gemstones is
Can we do, like,
hard.
Cartoon characters? Can we do, like,
Well, we did Disney characters. Because we had Cinderella and all that stuff. Not Disney.
I do movie characters. Do a TV show
TV
character.
Show characters.
Do Gilligan's Island characters.
Okay, that you wouldn't have enough. Actually, that's what we're running into right now, is everybody keeps using the same ones that they're familiar with, and people tell us to Google it. I don't have time to Google it. We go down through that list, and if it's not used, the first one that posts a name that's not used,
boom,
that's what
that's
it is.
That's why we need easy ones. Broad spectrum. Do you have any movies there is out there that you can just name? You can name stuff Bruce, Fred, Bob, Willie. And there will be a movie with a character in it, I guarantee you.
Yeah, but they have to tell us what
Jemima.
Movie.
I mean, your Aunt Jemima.
Nope, he's better there. There is no Aunt Jemima. That's pancake syrup, and there's no...
I'm sure there's a TV character. Google it.
No, it's trademarked. By the pancake company or whatever.
Really?
I think so. Aunt Jemima's pancake? Yes!
Pish posh.
It's
Don't have to call her aunt, just call her Jemima.
Oh, nobody said we couldn't use it. I just said movies and that can't use it unless they pay for the rights. So
we can name one Bruce. Bruce Almighty. We can name one,
Yep. But anyway.
Ooh, we can name one, like, islands. Like, you have the Bahamas, the Keys, Mexico.
Okay, Mexico is not an island. Iceland is. England is. Australia is a country, but it also is an island, so. But there's not enough islands either.
I noticed that. That's what when I said Mexico, I realized, hey, I am not very smart.
Not an island. Okay. It has a coast, but it's not an island.
And we could name them after our viewers.
That would be awesome. Yeah.
Everybody got a sheep named after them.
Okay, we're going to have to work on that one for next year.
See, guys, you guys have to
have anyway.
Rich. Come on.
How did we get off on this topic? Because things are going to be coming due here in the next couple of months, so we're going to have
I told you it'd be about 5 minutes. I had to watch the last 5 minutes, and then we'll watch the beginning. It's been about 5 minutes.
All right, we're off of here. We will talk to you guys later.
Peace
now
out,
just
Girl Scout.
Weird.
All right. Bye-bye.